Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the Keyword Planner in Google AdWords. The Keyword Planner lets you research keywords for your AdWords campaigns, but you can also use the tool to research keywords for your website content, blog posts, and more. As we'll see, we can enter some initial keywords to then see a whole range of keyword suggestions. Along with the suggested keywords, there are different metrics and insights we can make use of by using the tool. For example, we can quickly see if there's lots of people competing for a particular keyword. In this video, we're going to cover the latest version of the Keyword Planner. Google has recently made some changes, so we'll also compare the old and the new versions of the tool. Let's get started. Before you use the Keyword Planner, you'll need to create an AdWords account. This also means you'll need to enter billing details for the account. So if you're not using Google AdWords, but you want to use the planner, you'll need to make sure that any campaigns are paused inside the account. Otherwise, you will be charged if your ads are displayed and clicked. The new Keyword Planner has been streamlined. Instead of being able to select targeting refinements before we begin researching keywords, we now select them after we've entered our initial keywords. Here's a quick look at the old Keyword Planner. You can see there are options to customize the targeting and options for filtering the keyword suggestions that are provided in the tool. The old version also provided slightly different details for the suggested keywords. Here we can see an example of the results we might see in the Keyword Planner. The little icon to the right of each keyword allowed you to see trends for each individual keyword and also access Google Trend data. This option isn't available in the new version. We can also see a suggested bid amount in the old version. This is replaced by a low and high range estimate to be at the top of the paid results. Now let's head into Google AdWords and look at the new Keyword Planner. You'll find the Keyword Planner by clicking the Tools icon. At the top of the planner, you can enter up to three initial keywords to begin your research. You can enter the URL of a page on your website or both. Below this, there is an option to enter existing keywords that you've already researched to see metrics and forecasts for these keywords. We're going to select the option to find new keywords and enter our initial keywords for our research. Now we can click Get Started. At the top of the Keyword Planner, we can now adjust the targeting. For example, if we want to research keywords for a particular geographic location, we can change the targeting. Moving down, we can see the overall trend for the suggested keywords. You can change the date range for the trend on the right. There are also options to change this from a timeline to view a breakdown of different devices and locations. We can then see the suggested keywords along with their average monthly search volume. The competition column will give you an indication of how competitive each keyword is. The more advertisers competing for visibility, the higher the competition. You'll see this shown as high, medium, or low competition. Next, we see the impression share column. This tells you the coverage you're currently achieving for any keywords you're already bidding on in your account. In this example, the column is blank, which tells us we're not currently displaying any ads for the keywords in our account. We can then see suggested bid amounts to display in the top positions for each keyword. We're given two metrics for this. We have a low range and a high range estimate. This gives us an idea of the types of bids we'd need in order for our ads to be above the organic results. And if you've linked Google AdWords to Google Search Console, you'll also see metrics for any keywords where your website is shown in the organic search results. When researching keywords, look for keywords that are closely related to your products, services, or offering. Then you'll need to balance the potential search volume, competition, and estimated bid amounts to decide if the keywords are suitable for your campaigns. You'll need to spend time going through all the suggestions and decide if they're appropriate or not. Once you have a list of suitable keywords, you'll need to add them to ad groups and decide on the keyword match types you want to use. To learn more about keyword match types, check out the link to my tutorial in the description below this video. Once you are bidding on the keywords, you'll want to monitor their performance and make sure they're driving the conversions and results you're looking for from your campaigns. So that's how you can use the new Keyword Planner inside Google AdWords. Once you've researched your keywords, along with choosing a keyword match type, you should also ensure that your ad groups are well structured. Ideally, you should aim for no more than 5 to 10 keywords in each ad group. This allows you to show highly targeted ads for those keywords as people are searching on Google. Now, we have focused on using the keyword suggestions to target keywords for our AdWords campaigns, but you can also use the tool to identify keywords you want to use for organic optimization. For example, you can look for keywords that have a high number of average monthly searches and then create content targeting that particular keyword. Are you using the Keyword Planner? I'd love to know. Tell me in the comments below. And also tell me if you have any extra tips you'd like to share. Take a moment to subscribe to my channel to receive the latest tips and tutorials. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.